A very happy Republic Day to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 26 Jan, Sunday, here you can see seven eminent personalities have been selected, four of them posthumously for the top honor. So it is late BJP leader Arun Jaitley and former finance minister, late BJP leader and former external affairs minister Sushma Swaraj, late socialist leader and former union minister George Fernandez, and even late seer of Pejavar, known for reforms in Hindu religion, Vishvesha Tirtha Swami. So these are the four of the posthumously awarded Padma Vibhushans this year. Padma Vibhushans, Padma Shri, and the topmost honor, and Padma Bhushan, Padma Shri, then comes Padma Bhushan, then Padma Vibhushan, and the topmost honor is Bharat Ratna. So these awards are announced on Republic Day. So four are posthumous Padma Vibhushan, which is one lower than the Bharat Ratna. And then you have Anirudh Jagannath, former Prime Minister of Mauritius. Then Channulal Mishra, Hindustani classical singer from Varanasi, and MC Mary Kom, who is boxer, Olympic medalist, and also now a Rajya Sabha member. So these are other three who have been awarded Padma Vibhushan this year. So seven Padma Vibhushans have been awarded. So you can see even Indians or people of Indian origin who are not Indian citizens are also awarded Padma Vibhushans and Padma Awards. So you should know about that. And even Bharat Ratna for that matter. Like the popular name is Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan, who after independence, his region became part of Pakistan. So still he got Padma Award because he got the Bharat Ratna Award because he fought for India's independence. And he did not want India to divide as such too. Then here you have India-Brazil Inc. Action Plan to Deepen Strategic Partnership. So 15 Memorandums of Understandings, MOUs, have been signed between India and Brazil. You should know, we have been discussing this for quite a few days now, that Brazil President Jair Bolsonaro was the chief guest at the Republic Day celebrations this year. So on the sidelines of that, 15 MOUs have been signed between the two countries, deals on investment cooperation, facilitation, bioenergy, etc. Then below you have PMO reviews measures to combat coronavirus threat. So PMO has reviewed India's preparedness to deal with the outbreak of new coronavirus, because of global concern about increasing number of cases in China and number of fatalities too. And here you have Rajasthan resolution against CAA. So we had seen Kerala Legislative Assembly passing a resolution against Citizenship Amendment Act, which is a law of the central government, and even Punjab followed it, and now even Rajasthan Assembly has passed such a resolution. On page 4 you have Supreme Court order on Satluj issue violated. So this is Haryana Pradesh Congress Committee President and Rajya Sabha MP Kumari Selja, who is speaking on this issue, that the Supreme Court had validated Haryana's right on water of Satluj Yamuna Link Canal. So you should know about Satluj Yamuna Link Canal. So Punjab and Haryana are the two states involved in this river water dispute. And Punjab, Haryana, you should know, were single state. But when the bifurcation took place in 1956 on the basis of language, so linguistic states were formed in the country. So at that time, Haryana's share of water was reduced, and it was decided that Punjab and Haryana would share the water accordingly. But then later, Punjab stepped back on its promise, and this resulted in this dispute. The link canal was not formed, which was supposed to be formed. So the Supreme Court has also adjudicated on this. So you should know about this issue. On page 9, you have a bid to restore coral reefs in Gulf of Kutch using biorocks. So technology helps corals to counter the threat posed by global warming. So this is what Zoological Survey of India scientists are saying, that technology can be used, and that is a step being taken in Gulf of Kutch in India too by Zoological Survey of India. So what has been used for the first time is biorocks. So these are mineral accretion which is done through technology. So these are installed to restore corals. And below you have Supreme Court affirms 3% quota for disabled in PSUs. So, three judge bench of the Supreme Court has granted relief to persons with disabilities across the country by allowing reservation in promotion in all groups for those employed in public sector jobs. So, there will be 3% reservation, both in direct recruitment as well as in promotions. On page 10, we have the list of Padma Bhushans and Padma Shris. Padma Bhushans we saw on the front page. So this year, 16 Padma Bhushan and 118 Padma Shri awards have also been announced. So these are, Padma Vibhushan comes second highest, Padma Bhushan third highest, and Padma Shri is fourth highest. Civilian awards as such. In Padma Shri. Padma Shri, these are, Padma are three awards. So, but then if you talk of highest civilian award is Bharat Ratna. So this may be a little incorrect to mention Padma Bhushan as second highest. If Bharat Ratna is highest civilian award, then Padma Vibhushan is second highest. Then comes Padma Bhushan, then comes Padma Shri. On international page, you have China toll hits 41. 41 people have died of new coronavirus in China. And now the virus has been detected in Australia as well as in European Union. On business page also, there is this one coverage. Are regulations a boon or bane for technology? So, Google CEO pitches to regulate artificial intelligence has stirred up a debate among industry players. So there are renewed debates about regulation of newer technologies such as artificial intelligence. So, some regulations may be needed to keep a check on technology, but putting too many barriers may stifle innovation is what is the viewpoint. But Google CEO Sundar Pichai pitched for regulation of artificial intelligence in a recent article as such. Then on Sundays, you have this FAQ page, frequently asked questions. So here you can see first article is Let's Face It. So this is regarding facial recognition technologies. So global attempts at regulation of these technologies are also being made. So technologies are used, but how they are used, especially by private sector as well as by government, there needs to be restrictions on it and clear rules and regulations. And this is running for president the democratic way. So this is regarding the presidential elections in USA, which are steps are being taken now. So this is needed out here. And this is, should the Bezos phone hack be cause for alarm? So this was the news regarding MBS, Mohammed bin Salman, the crown prince of Saudi Arabia. He was accused by UN experts, UN cyber experts, of being behind the phone hack of Jeff Bezos, the head of Amazon. So are modern computing devices safe when it comes to issue of security, vulnerabilities in technology use is a question being raised. Also, we had the infamous Pegasus case in which was seen that WhatsApp voice call, as such WhatsApp call was used to steal information from the phones. And this was being used through Pegasus, which is software, which is of Israeli company, which claims that it uses this this technology only to governments. And even in India, some activists as such had their phone infected through Pegasus. Then on Sundays, you also have science and technology coverage. So here, first one is regarding treatment for prostate cancer. That is fine. Then this is regarding why there are more men than women in fields of STEM, that is science, technology, engineering, and medicine. So this is there. Then this talks about how there are high pesticide levels in potato and carrots in Nilgiris. But important is regarding coronavirus. But this again speaks about coronavirus cases. They have been estimated to be at around 4,000 in Wuhan city in China. So this talks about the mode of estimation. So there's no scientific coverage here on the disease too. So you may skip the science and technology page today too. Then also on Sundays, you have dispatches coverage, which picks up important international news. So first was is regarding Brazil. So it is said Brazil's top government leaders are accused of using racial slurs and Nazi slogans to attack their rivals. So we had already discussed it earlier too. Brazil President Jair Bolsonaro, who is the chief guest for the Republic Day celebrations of India this year, he is accused of racial slurs and using Nazi slogans to attack the rivals, his rivals, political rivals. So top government leaders are being used. He also is a climate skeptic, as we had seen earlier. And Amazon forest, huge forest fire was seen during his tenure. And he's just being sworn in as the president. Second is regarding US. It says all the presidents, men and women. So this is regarding President Donald Trump's defense team at the Senate trial in his impeachment process. This you can skip. Then this third article is on Japan. It is regarding the minister in Japan who is on paternity leave. So he is taking a break for childcare. So this is considered as a revolutionary step in Japan. And this last news is regarding Russia. It is regarding Putin's plan to change Russia's institution. So this is important. This has been prominently in news too. We have discussed it in detail. So these are changes which President Vladimir Putin is proposing because his two-term presidency will come to an end. Earlier too, he was president and he modified the constitution, became the prime minister for some time and allowed himself to become the president again. And now when again his term as two-term as president is getting over, he is looking for himself, you know, a new role as such. So changes have been proposed in Russia's institutions, like he wants parliament to have more power. So maybe it is speculated he may become the speaker of the parliament now. So he may take up another role. So it says the proposed changes would allow the president to remain powerful even after the end of his term. So this is important. Then the last pages have sports related news. So that is it. These were the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asha.com. Thank you.